There's a voice in your head, and it's saying, I'm not worthy. I'm not worthy to have relationships, friends, and connections like that. I'm not worthy to receive offers and opportunities like that. I'm not worthy to make that kind of money, to get that kind of job, to start that kind of project, or inspire that kind of change. I'm not worthy to become the person that I want to be. That is the voice of imposter syndrome. Imposter syndrome is the nagging suspicion that deep down inside, you're a fraud. That you're completely fooling yourself for thinking that you have the power to create interesting results in your life. Whenever you make a positive move in a new direction, this is the voice that speaks out in protest, reminding you to sit back down and stay in your place. You're not interesting. You're not influential. You're not significant. You don't deserve to be happy. Who do you think you are? Sometimes, when we hear that voice, it makes us wish that someone would come along and just tell us everything is going to be easy. Well, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to tell you that we live inside of some friendly, fluffy, gigantic rainbow cloud that can't wait to make all your wishes come true, regardless of what you decide to do. I'm not going to tell you that all you gotta do to live the good life is to close your eyes and visualize while the cosmic genie makes it all happen as you passively sleepwalk through your own life. I'm not going to tell you anything like that, but I am going to ask you to consider two words. Why not? Instead of trying to come up with a bunch of knockdown arguments to prove that you deserve this or you're good enough for that, why not flip the burden of proof entirely? For every single thing you want to do in life, I want you to ask, why not? Someone is going to travel the world. Someone is going to write the next amazing book. Someone is going to design that brilliant product. Someone's going to land the next impressive gig. Why can't that be you? If you put yourself in a situation where you say, I will never follow any of my dreams unless I come up with an airtight, logical argument proving that I am worthy enough, your dreams will never get off the ground. But I know you're hearing that voice again. And let me guess, it's probably saying something like, yeah, that's inspirational, but you see, I grew up on the wrong side of the tracks and I don't have any big connections and I don't have a rich uncle and I grew up in a city where those kinds of things aren't even happening anyway, so I don't think any of that applies to me. And guess what? I'm not going to argue against any of those beliefs, because all of those things are probably true for you right now. But again, I ask you, why not? Someone is going to learn something new today. Why not you? Someone is going to dedicate the next few months or the next few years to transforming themselves from a beginner to an expert. Why not you? There is someone out there who isn't very good at communication. There's someone out there right now who has no idea how to build relationships or has never picked up a paintbrush in their entire life. And guess what that someone is going to do? They're going to nudge themselves ever so slightly out of the comfort zone. And they're going to put one foot in front of the other. And they're going to take small steps and they're going to stick with the process no matter how ugly it looks, until they eventually come out on the other side and say, I did it. I put the time in. I put the work in. I put my energy in. I gave my all. And even though I may not be better than everyone else, I am definitely a better version of myself. Why can't that be you? Why can't that be your voice? Instead of carrying around this huge burden of justifying your entire existence and waiting endlessly for someone to come along and pick you, why not pick yourself? I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. I'm not sure if I'm worthy enough. I'm not sure if I have what it takes to live my dreams. But I know that I don't need to know any of those things in order to know I have as much of a right as anyone else to try something new, to learn something new, to ask something new. And so do you. Because that's the beautiful thing about history. In every generation, someone comes along and figures out a way to do the very things they weren't worthy to do. And someone's going to figure it out again. Will it be you? Why not?